answer to Rome. In this lesson, we are going to expand on the knowledge that we already know about finding derivatives of natural logarithms. And we're going to expand it to be able to find the derivative of logarithms regardless of what base we have, base A. Now, we're going to have a new rule for this, and if you memorize it, then you can do these problems very, very quickly. If you don't have this memorized, and it's pretty close to the derivative rule we had for natural logarithms, but if you don't have this new rule memorized, I'm looking at the u-substitution one here, then you can remember what you learned back in Algebra 2 or pre-calculus about changing the base of logarithms. And so the first one example I'm going to do of three, I'm going to do twice, once using this new rule and once where we change the base from base A to base E, or natural logarithm. And the next two examples, I'm going to convert them into natural logarithms. I am going to change the base so we can use those skills that we already learned in a previous section. And that way you can see how to do the problems, you know, again, if you don't have this memorized. So, definition of a logarithmic function to base A. If A is a positive real number, again, not equal to 1, and X is any positive real value, because we can't take the log of, a value unless it is positive, then the logarithmic function to base A is denoted by log base A of X and is defined as log base A of X is equal to 1 over the natural log of A times the natural log of X. Basically, what they're showing you here again is, and I'm going to show you where this comes from, unless you hopefully remember the change of base formula from Algebra 2 or pre-calculus, is they're kind of, with this definition, showing you that you can use the derivative rule that you've already learned in your previous section or previous lesson. Derivatives of natural logarithms for base A. Let A be a positive real number, we're not equal to 1, and let B, U, for the U substitution, be differentiable function of X. And let's just go to the U substitution here. The derivative with respect to X of log base A of U is equal to 1 over the natural log of A times U times the derivative of U with respect to X. Well, you can see that 1 over U, or that U prime over U, that should look familiar from us finding derivatives of natural log functions. And we see the natural log of A here in the base. So they have, with this rule that you can again memorize, change that base from base A to base E, which I'll show you how to do, or remind you actually, because should not be new. if I have, like, say, Y is equal to log base A of X, now there is a change of base formula. If you remember it, you're going to know this answer immediately. And you can see where this comes from, but if you don't remember that change of base formula, or and just to practice our skills for properties of logarithms, I can change this base by, well, going from, I can take this function and go into exponential form. So I can say, well, let's see here, log base, I'm taking the logarithm of something, and what you get out of a logarithm is an exponent. Hopefully this is all unnecessary because of all the work we've done with logarithms recently, but just in case, or maybe you're not watching my whole series of videos. So here we have an equation in logarithmic form, and here it is in exponential form. Base, exponent, and then in exponential form, this is actually the answer, what you're taking the log of. So we have a to the y is equal to x. Now, if I want to solve this equation for y, just like I get, like again, for years now, right, you need logarithms to solve for equations when the variable is in the exponent, and I want to solve for y. But I want to get into the natural log function, so I'm going to take the natural log of a to the y is equal to the natural log of x, bring this power down out front, divide both sides by natural log of a, and voila, we have our definition of a logarithmic function to base a right here. So that's where this comes from. It's just simply changing the base from base A to natural log. Let's get on to that first example. Bam! Alright, so here's the change of base formula. This is what I just showed you how to work through the steps of in the previous screen, but thought maybe just having the formula be nice for your notes if you needed it to remind you of what it was. I know you've had that before. So I'm not going to show all those steps for changing this base. We have a log base 5. I want to go into the natural log or log base e. So we can see that it's going to be this expression that you're taking the log of goes in the numerator, and the old base ended up in the denominator. So we're going to have y is equal to the natural log of 4 x squared plus x over the natural log of 5. And if you want that broken apart even more to see it in small steps, we have y is equal to 1 over the natural log of 5 times the natural log of 4x squared plus x. And you can you're going to start seeing very, very quickly, again, where this new rule comes into play. And honestly, again, if you can memorize it, use it. It's going to be a little bit less work, but I haven't added too many steps in here. And I'm already at a point where I can use the rules and the skills that we practice when doing the derivative of natural logs, because I already have a natural log right there. My u is going to be 4x squared plus x, and my derivative of u with respect to x is equal to 8x plus 1. And if I cover up that natural log of a that's in the denominator, that's 1 over u times the derivative of u with respect to x. That is the rule that we just learned, like I said in the previous section. So our final answer, y prime, excuse me, is equal to 1 over the natural log of 5 times u prime is going to be 8x plus 1 over u, which is equal to 4x squared plus x. And voila, I mean, other than just writing this as one fraction, which maybe I should, we're done with finding our derivative. Now, of course, there it is. 1 over the derivative of log base a, not natural log, of u is 1 over natural log of a. We got that from converting into our, you know, log base e or natural log, and there it is in the denominator. A, natural log of a in the denominator. Derivative of u dx, or just simply u prime over u. There's my u prime. The derivative of my inside function over u. And that's the end of our first example. The next one I'm going to let you do on your own. I'll bring it up here and just reveal the solutions one step at a time to allow you to practice it as well. Bam! Voila! Y prime is equal to 6x over 2 times natural log of 3 times 3x squared plus 1. If you, for students, or if you have a little bit of trouble with fractions, I kind of like to let this this natural log of 3 come out and show that 1 over natural log of 3, and then bring down that power of 1 half so you can more easily see how the numerators and denominators line up. And just mixed up the notation a little bit, showing you as u prime here instead of du dx. And instead of y prime, just to get you used to both of those notations. Our last example is, of course, going to be involving logarithms, and we'll have to do some expansion with these before, or we should, before we try and find the derivative of the original function given. Let's find the derivative of log base 3 of x squared times the square root of 3x plus 1 divided by 5. And again, this will be best, I think, tackled if you do the expansion of the logarithm first. So we're going to have y is equal to log base 3. Now in the numerator, we have, you know, basically what? We have the product of, we have two factors. We have multiplication. So that's going to be addition. So we're going to have log base 3 of x squared plus the log base 3 of the square root of 3x plus 1 minus, and then the denominator we just have a constant, so we can, it's going to be 9 minus the log base 3 of 5. Okay, and I'm going to go ahead and erase this right now and just, you know, normally we want to deal with these radicals and fraction exponents, so we're going to take that square root and of course change that to a power of 1 half. Okay, now let's get these converted into natural logarithms. So we're going to have y is equal to the natural log of x squared over natural log of 3 plus the natural log of 3x plus 1 to the 1 half power. I'm trying not to skip any steps so you guys can follow along. Some of you may be saying, well, why don't you just move these powers up front right now? And I'm going to next. And I don't really care about converting the log base 3 of 5 to a natural logarithm, because it's a constant, so when we find the derivative, it's going to be 0. We're going to move these powers out front and get y is equal to 2 times the natural log of x over natural log of 3. Now, you can write it like that, or if you really want to just separate the coefficient away from the variable factor, you can write that coefficient out front and write that as 2 over the natural log of 3 times the natural log of x, and that's how I'm going to do the rest of these. We're going to, like before here, this is 1 over natural log of 3, and we're going to bring that 1 half out front. So it's going to be 1 half times 1 over natural log of 3, and then our natural log coefficient with the variable in it. So we're going to have 1 over 2 natural log of 3 times the natural log of 3x plus 1 minus, again, log base 3 of 5, which is going to become 0 when we find the derivative. So our derivative is going to be, kind of running out of room here, well, this is just 1 over x, so that's going to be, or the derivative of natural log of x is 1 over x, so we have 2 over the natural log of 3 times x plus, here, with a u substitution, our u is going to be 3x plus 1, and the derivative of this inside function is going to be 3. So just doing that u prime over u a little bit here and skipping at least one step, we have 3 in the numerator, and in the denominator we have 2 times the natural log of 3 times 3x plus 1 minus, and of course this is 0, and whoops, forgot my derivative mark. So y prime is equal to 2 over natural log of 3 of x times x plus 3 over 2 times natural log of 3 times 3x plus 1. And you don't need the 0 there. This is, the derivative is done, so this can be your final answer, or you can find common denominators and write this as one single fraction, but I know on the test, you know, like again, I said this in a previous video, don't oversimplify. Simplify to where your teacher expects you to simplify to, or just simply do the problem until you get to a point where that would be acceptable on, say, if you're going to take a standardized test, like maybe an AP calculus test. If this is correct and then you make a mistake in the simplification process, try to clean up your answer, and maybe they're not expecting you to have to do that on the, say, AP calculus test, you could lose points even though this is correct and you did the calculus right, but you made a small mistake in your cleanup or simplification of your answer. So don't oversimplify and possibly lose some points that you otherwise would have had. So, I'm Mr. Taroop. Bam! Go do your homework!